No. We only draw blades in service to the guild.
I don't stink of fish. I'm surrounded by a delicious bouquet.
The quality of the steel from Matisse is excellent. Have you seen the blades they're making up there?
Oh, yes. I've got an in with the foreman. Getting some for a great price.
Bah! Damn you, tallies and your nepotism. I need a step stool to get a fair deal around here.
Thank you. The feel of fine silk against soft fur. This one can't imagine a sleeker sensation.
Oh, I hope no one's hurt. This one shudders to think of the damage the beast could do. A 100 apologies, Walker, but the show is postponed for now. If you purchased a ticket, this one will gladly refund your gold. Oh, forgive Tahara. Her worry gets the better of her. One of my menagerie's most terrifying beasts escaped from its cage. I turned my back for only a moment to speak to an onlooker, you see, and pow! The monster burst free! Oh, a vicious beast with ravening jaws and beady black eyes. The Brett and Tahara bought it from called the creature Bertel. But do not let its silly name fool you. You seem capable. If you find Bertel, I will gladly share some of my profits with you. This one is humbled by your generosity, Walker. She will see you fully compensated for the danger of this task. Of course, Tahara will answer what she can. I warn you, though, you may learn more than you'd like. Yes, yes, of course. It stalks on 4 clawed feet, standing as high at the shoulder as Tahara is at her waist. Its fur is blood-burnished gold, and its floppy ears dangle like curtains at the cheek, framing a muzzle filled with yellow teeth. Yes, yes, oh, Walker. You will never meet a more fearsome creature. To think the noble wolf bred into such a compact frame of death and horror. In the Khajiit tongue, Ta'agra, the word for dog, means death. Can you believe that? Well, no. Dog just means dog. But still, you know what Tahara is telling you.
Baker.
Don't let these meatheads get to you. A good set of lightweight armor is worth every bit of effort you put into it. We tan, weave, stitch, you name it. People in search of medium and light armor come to us. This requires fibers, leather, and a work table like those found in town. We also seek out style books and special ingredients for more advanced work. Yes, of course. During the tailoring process, we can choose a special trait for the work. It takes research to discover these techniques, but it's well worth the effort. Reinforced buckles, intricate detail work, each brings a special benefit. Well, the piece can be improved even more through the use of tannins. These elements can enhance the value and quality of your work. Just...
They say the daggers are coming. Just a few years ago, it was the dark elves are coming. Either way, our children are too big to hide.
Quality wares.
This business about the Covenant invasion makes you want to crawl in a hole and drink, don't it?
I only make fair deals. You get your...
Take a look at what I have for sale. You never can tell when you'll need something.
Mara, help me. An adventurer? Oh, praise you, Mara, for hearing my prayers. Please, newcomer, I'm desperate for help. My son, Arathel, has gone missing. No one will tell me what happened to him. Yes, I'm sorry. The last time I saw him, he was agitated, scared. I asked him what was wrong, but he left without a word. The guards arrived later. They said he turned himself in, that he was involved in a plot to kill our Sapiarch Icantar. No, he vanished. They say he escaped. Can you believe it? Why would he turn himself in only to escape a few hours later? They're hiding something, I know it. Please, Caraval, help me find my boy. He would never hurt anyone, I swear it. You have a perfect heart, newcomer. None of my neighbors would lift a finger to help me. The guards placed Arathel in a cell beneath the Kin Lady's manor. I'm told the Justiciar of Remand is there now, a mer named Telerion. He must know something. No, Icantar treats us like family. Arathel is Icantar's apprentice, you see? He was so proud when the attestation came through. He's been a bit withdrawn, though. I found some Aprax literature in his room. But it's just a phase, right? Right. You're new to the Isle, I apologize. Apraxic Mer are people who, for whatever reason, were expelled from the greater elven community. Most Aprax labor for years to re-enter society. Others choose to remain in exile. I feel very sorry for them. Some do, yes. Treatises on class warfare, religious hypocrisy, that sort of thing. A lot of young Mer take a liking to it. I think it's healthy to push back a bit. Not too much, of course, but a bit. Rumor has it that a famous Aprax called the Mother of Rats lives in the city, but I've never met her. And even if I did, we're forbidden from speaking with her. Oh, that sounds awful, doesn't it? It's just the way things are here, I'm afraid.
So, you're the one that saved the queen, eh? You don't look that special.
I'm a little annoyed that the guard won't tell me how long my husband will be inside the monastery. But we waited months to get here. I can wait a little longer.
We have been delivered unto a trying time. New people come to our land with new faiths. But our order will rise above.